lights out and we are go. Lopez then starting from pole position, gets a superb launch. Look at Lopez charging towards that first corner. Iagüero already fast away too far on the Team Asia. He's got through on Dixon.
Dixon keen to get past Agüero as quickly as possible to try and close that gap back down. And we know Agüero is a difficult rider to overtake.
It's another lap being led by Lopez then. Over the line we go. He was close to track this time, wasn't he? Coming out the chicane was Aldeguer. All right, here we go then. Agüero. Dixon's gone through on Agüero into the first corner. So Dixon now sensing that Acosta is coming. He's probably getting the pit board about the 37's hot streak. So at the moment, as it stands, Jake Dixon on course for what will be his best Grand Prix finish. You just saw there that graphic, a whole bunch of third places. Second though, not what he's here for, at his beloved Assen. He's here for the first victory. He said pre-weekend, he loves Assen, probably his favourite circuit. The next two races, of course, Silverstone, his home Grand Prix in early August. You do feel that big, big opportunities for Jake Dixon to take the victory here, and he is right now on Lopez's case. We start lap 10 of 22, and here comes Jake Dixon. He's going to go for it on the inside. He took Agüero, didn't he, there on the previous lap. That's where Dixon's strong. He's got real confidence on the front end of that Kalex machine, breaking hard in the first corner.
Dixon ever so slightly wide there into the Timber Chicane as he followed Alonso Lopez across the line. Lopez a quarter of a second clear, and look, it's brought Iagüero right onto the back of Dixon again. Dixon maintains second.
At the moment, Alonso Lopez has led the lot and he's still resisting in the braking zone into the first corner. That's where Dixon has been really, really strong. Here comes Agüero then, trying to find a way through on Dixon, while at the same time he's trying to attack Dixon while defend against Acosta here.
Dixon this time does go through. He got the run out of the final chicane. Dixon cleanly through before they hit the brakes for Harbaugh. Can he stay ahead as they now tip it into turn two? He can.
Dixon's made a big mistake. Sorry, Lewis. Jake Dixon has fluffed his lines there. Just he was trying to make a decisive break. Well, we've seen Arbolino, we've seen Acosta make big mistakes and pay for it in turn five. Well, this time around, it was Jake Dixon. He got in really, really hot. He was leading comfortably by nearly 3/10 through the first sector. And now he's relegated back to third. It's a girl that leads here in Assen. Oh, Acosta! I thought he was down. I can't believe how did Pedro Acosta, defying gravity there on the brakes, tipping it left right into Timber Chicane. I thought he was down. I was just about to say Acosta has crashed. Somehow, cat-like reflexes, he picks it up. Jake Dixon as well just fires in the fastest of the Grand Prix. We talked about his great late race prowess. It's coming to the fore again here. Dixon, a 136.697. He is going to have to work so, so hard over these last two laps now and three corners, because the pressure from Dixon is coming.
We saw Dixon earlier go past Iagüero into the first corner. He's doing it again.
They almost touched, and Agüero's going to go wide. Agüero's going to go off the circuit. Nothing he can do about that. But it is going to be through the Timber Chicane for the final time. Pure and utter Dutch delight for Dixon as he takes his career first victory in the Moto2 World Championship. There is your race winner. He punches the tank, he punches the screen. Absolute delirium for Dixon as he's a first-time Grand Prix winner. Jake Dixon in dreamland here.
To see more from the biggest MotoGP season ever, click here to subscribe.